our generation. I don't know why. And I think a lot of people know the word and know the definition, but don't know how it feels and how to do it. And so I think it's really important to teach like Gen Z what hope is and how to feel it and how to have hope.
Yeah, I mean, it is interesting about your generation because it's one that has grown up not knowing a time before the internet. So you have access to everything, even the worst, darkest parts of the world. So being able to cope with that is something that I think is important to tell everyone. So it's the first song that you've released since your debut album, Just the Beginning. Is a lot of the material that you're working on now, like, similarly message-driven? Like, hope and thinking about the audience that you have now?
I don't want to say.
You don't want to say?
No. It's just, I think, I don't know, I never really, like, I never think I'm going to write all my songs, like, about hope, or I'm going to write my songs for this or that. It's
sure.
Just, like,
it's probably still very much taking its shape now, too.
Yeah, and I'm definitely still, like, you know, learning and figuring out my sound and who I am as a writer, and I think the main thing is just, like, whatever is on my mind and what's on my mind.
Yeah. Where are you finding your inspiration these days? Without, like, giving too much away. Is it from, like, relationships with other people that you talk to, or is it from, like, watching things happen on the news, or watching a movie?
No, I just kind of make up stuff.
So it's kind of like you're writing stories, right? You're
yes.
Drawing from it, like, imagining how things might go.
Especially hard because of how young I am, because I would record a song and then like 3 months into it I'd have to keep going back and recording the old songs because my voice keeps changing.
Oh. So that was like a technical struggle.
So that was really frustrating. But I think the main thing that it taught me was I love performing. It's like my favorite thing. So I loved performing the Just the Beginning album and being on tour, and that's like my main motivation right now is just to get the album out to go on tour and give us a
What has the experience of performing that music live taught you about what you want to bring into the next kind of body of work that you do?
It's really taught me that if you don't really like words that much, just to keep working on it, because I kept
to further explain.
Like, if there were a certain line that you're like, oh, that doesn't seem that good, but whatever, and keep going, no. I did that so many times, and it doesn't go away.
Yeah.
Like, because it would only get worse through the tour. I would be singing right. Every time. Like, if I did, like, a certain line, or I thought it was, like, just bad, every time it would just make me cringe, and I'll never do that.
Any hints about what that might be? What are the words that, like...
Insane sometimes, I feel like, has the weakest lyrics, and I thought that I was fine with it at the time, and during tour, I never got over it. Like, every time I sing that song, I'm like, oh my god, why did I do this?
Do you think that you'd ever go back and do, like, a Just the Beginning Reloaded album, where you kind of, like, fine-tune those things, where you just want to keep going and work on the next project?
No, I don't think I would, because then you wouldn't be able to see me grow through my music, and I think Just the Beginning album, like, if you've heard it, has tons of different sounds. Some are, like, so pop, and others are slightly more, like, indie or chill, and I think it really helped me on what my sound is, like, kind of production-wise,
mm-hmm.
because I've never produced, or, you know, I don't produce, but you know what I mean? Like, I've never...
been in the studio setting.
Yeah, exactly.
And getting acquainted with all that stuff.
You still choose your sound, and you make the production with it. And I think that it really helped me with what I want the sound to be and all that kind of stuff.
Cool. Well, you're about to open for Imagine Dragons this summer. Were you excited? Scared? How are you feeling about that?
I'm so excited. I'm not scared at all. usually I get scared, like, last minute. But I am so excited. I just picked out my dress. And I've just been living in it. And, like, it's so hard because I have these followers on Instagram. And, like, I want to post it so bad.
But then, like, you have to wait. You can't spoil
it's
it.
It's so pretty, though.
And it blooms out so, like, it's big.
Yeah, it's so big. But it's, like, okay big because it's kind of, like, sheer with, like, something fitted underneath. So it's, like, really big, but, like, it's all I'm going to get. It's great. And, like, then, like, I just moved a little bit and the whole thing moves. It's, like,
You definitely are a person who is, I think, like, invigorated by fashion. Is that something that you would ever want to, like, jump into in the future?
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely. I love fashion so much. Especially my favorite type of fashion is just, like, that super weird high fashion that just doesn't really make sense. But, like, I think it's great because they just...
You love the moment.
They don't care. They don't care at all. Like, they don't care about anything about the rules or, like, they... Whatever. They just do whatever, you know?
Yeah.
If you want... red eyes, have red eyes. If you want blue lips, have blue lips. You want no lips, you have no lips, you know?
Well, maybe we'll see some makeup experiments on the road.
Lips.
Yeah. Well, you are performing later tonight. Have you warmed up? Do you have a vocal warm-up that you might want to teach me?
I have a vocal warm-up that my vocal teacher that I can never go to tells me to do, and I never do.
So we'll wait. We'll see how things go in the performance. Yeah. Well, that's all the questions that I have, but there are a lot of people at home watching who have sent in questions.
Which camera is it?
This is a wide one, but we've got eyes everywhere. All these cameras on us. So the first question from fans. This first one is from Sasha the Singer.
Sasha the Singer?
Yeah. They asked, how do you find something you're passionate about and then put it in the song?
That's a good question. I think that once you find something you're passionate about, you'll know that you're passionate about it because you won't have to ask, like, am I passionate about this? Like, all you'll care about is just getting it out on paper and stuff like that.
Is there, like, a mental block at all from writing it in, like, an iPhone note and then putting it into a song that you would want other people to hear?
No.
No.
It's so easy. I feel like the second I write or make a song, like, video it on, like, the voice memos, I immediately can hear, like, the production. I can hear exactly how it works.
That's why you do things and why I don't. Next question is from Godly Goodness. They ask, would you ever consider acting? Because you did a great job on your music video for Clearly.
Thank you. I have been very interested in acting. I would love to act, but I would love to be in something more serious. I think my age holds me back a lot because a lot of the offers I get are more like a Disney fairy princess.
Or you're like a daughter in a family comedy.
Exactly. Yeah. But yeah, I would love to.
Would you ever, you are a writer, you're a songwriter, would you ever consider writing something for yourself to perform?
As an act?
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
No?
Yeah, no. I'm not good at that kind of stuff.
Fair enough. Maybe in the future you'll want to.
Yeah, maybe.
Who knows? Still a lot of time. Next question is from Lindy Windy Joy. Do you have any hidden talents? And if so, can you do them for us?
I love to dance.
I love to dance.
Yes, it's my favorite thing. But I would never dance for anyone but, like, my sister and myself.
What kind of dancing? Like break dancing?
No, just like lyrical kind of dancing. It's just so fun, and I'm always like, I'm so out of shape, so I'm always like dying on the floor.
It's more of a physical expression than a routine, I guess. The last one is from Karen IDK, 25. They ask, at this moment, who is your favorite female artist?
At the moment, and for a long time, my favorite female artist has been Adrienne.
Well, those are all the questions. Thank you guys so much at home for sending.
scared. It feels like a fool on this.
It'll be fun. Everybody here loves you.
Okay, can I choose?
Yep, go for it. I'm gonna read what it is. Do you not know what that means?
No, I can't do that one. Dirty dishes.
Do you have feelings about dirty dishes?
Okay. I just did. Okay. I was walking down the street with a concrete. I didn't mean to do it. You were in your office all alone, and I didn't mean to do it. And now I'm broke. I don't know how to fix it, cause I don't care.
Honestly, very good. That was amazing and hilarious. I know that I was very entertained, but I feel like everyone else might want the real thing also, now that we have this taste.
I'm sure you're ready for it? Like dying to buy my new single, Broke Yourself.
I would.
That doesn't rhyme.
I would buy an EP of all of those songs.
I mean, it could be a real song if you just like put some time into it.
Yeah,
and, like,
sure.
You know, the whole like, maybe you didn't call me back because you broke your cell phone. Like, that could be the plot
right.
of the song.
Or it's, like, always an excuse that somebody
let's,
has.
Let's make it happen.
Yeah. Do I get a credit on that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're all going to get, like, $2 because we're all going to share with each other.
Amazing. Well, you guys have you've been through a lot. Get ready for a very special performance from Grace VanderWaal. It's going to be amazing.
Yeah, you are.
Stay here now. Close curtains, cut the lights. Much darkness in my mind. It's gonna take me down. It's gonna take me all the roads I've been before. Same mistakes. Always got me shaken. And all the signs I once ignored. My denial. All the pain in my sorrow.
So, how do people live in the actual city? Very few. Okay, well, like, I'm sure all of you have come to the city a lot if you live in New York. And it can sometimes be a nasty place, you know? And I promised myself I would never write a city song. I always have disliked New York City songs with a passion, because I just feel like it makes people think that they're going to come to New York City and it's just going to be like, wow, like it's just got songs everywhere. And sometimes it smells, and sometimes it comes, I don't know. And so I was in New York. I was in some studio, these many buildings, and I was making a song for Just the Beginning. And I don't know, it just somehow started to become about the city. And I think kind of like the point of the song was, instead of coming to New York City and expecting the buildings to sing to you and to have all these crazy, like, fashionable people walk down the street, it's less about what the city gives to you and more what you're giving to the city and what you're seeing with your eyes and what you're making of it. And there it is. It's called City Song. Lastly, I just started singing this song live. because I enjoy singing it very much. And I hope that it wasn't a bad choice to put it as the last song, as it was a bit of a sad song. But I do enjoy singing it, and I just sang it for the first time live a couple months ago. And I was like, wow, why don't I sing that live? So I decided to sing it here as well.
Mm-hmm.